Greetings from Cody and Carol, who can't be here. We are absolutely passionately committed to supporting disabled people. I think it's more than just getting the system to work properly. We need another system. We need a better system. We need a reversal of decisions that have been made and heading in the opposite direction. We feel very much we've reached a fork in the road and we've taken entirely the wrong path. And it isn't just about getting that path a little bit smoother or a bit better, it's actually about taking a different path. We absolutely support the recommendations and the findings of the UN report, and I think we're talking about tactics here, which is where we're at in this meeting. I think we need to be calling very much for them to be implemented, but I think we need a dual strategy as a campaign. I think we need to work inside Parliament and I think we need to work outside Parliament campaigning as well, and that's something tried to model with Caroline, while Caroline's been in the chamber speaking on behalf of disabled people. I've been out on Westminster Bridge, blocking the bridge with disabled people, bringing traffic to a standstill to try and be visible. And I think visibility is an absolutely crucial point here, because what we've seen since 2010 is disabled people become less visible because of the consequences of the policies and what's been happening. Whether it be through the austerity programme, which has been closing libraries, making public spaces less accessible, less support disabled people to be in the community, just carrying out their everyday lives. They're being pushed away, and we have heard today that there are 10 million disabled people in the UK, but they're not being seen and they're not being heard. And the hard-won rights over the last few decades have been won because the slogan has been nothing about us without us. It's been disabled people at the front, visible, chaining themselves to buses to get changes to the bus system, the transport system, and that is what has won the victories. When I was working in the House of Commons in the early 1990s, one of my heroes was Tony Benn, and when he retired, he said, "I'm leaving the House of Commons to concentrate on politics." And it's his conviction that actually it's movements that change things, and we need a big movement to change things, and we need to be led by disabled people, but we need to include many, many more people in it. I think it's a landmark that many congratulations to everyone who's put the work in to get the UN to investigate and to come back with it. What is an absolute damning report, and it's an entirely inadequate response from this government. It's not just a government that's ignored some of the recommendations. It is an absolute scandal the way the government has responded to this report. I think we need to say it loudly. And I also think that because of the politicians who have pandered to the mantra of austerity, which we now know to be discredited and failed, they have allowed the agenda to shift too far in one direction. We've seen it happen over migration, now we've seen it happen over disability. And I think we need to be absolutely unequivocal and clear in where we stand on this, but also not be naive about the way that this government operates. And it operates around a policy of divide and rule. We're seeing it in the NHS. Without accepting responsibility for its policy failure, we're seeing it dividing GPs against those who work in aid. We're seeing it around schools, where it will now set parents against one another in competition to get their children into grammar schools. We've seen that around migration, where Indigenous populations are set against migrant populations in order to cover up the policy failure. And we've seen it absolutely loudly and clearly since 2010 over those so-called deserving welfare benefits recipients on the one hand, and those who are classed as undeserving. And I think we need to challenge this head on and say, no, this is not where the blame lies. The blame lies squarely with government. Let's come together. Let's learn the lessons of history. These aren't easy questions to crack, but if we can pursue the dual strategy of working within Parliament, but not putting all our store in what's been happening in Parliament, also outside, as David has mentioned, bringing the court cases, having the campaigns, raising awareness outside of Parliament, I think that is the direction that we need to take, and that's the direction that will eventually win us this battle. But let's not be under any illusions that there are any quick fixes about making the system work more effectively. That is not going to deliver